Thanks a lot to all of you for this overwhelming clapping in the beginning of the session. It really gives you some good energy. And I'm really thankful to GSFC University, to Vaishali ma'am, to Jhaveri sir, to Chetna ma'am, and to Shivani, and all of you students for inviting me here to share whatever I have understood about financial management in my last 20 years of career. First of all, like, you know, being on this side of stage and not on the other side, it is really giving me a feeling of nostalgia, because I'm really happy to see all of you, and I'm remembering my good old days of college days, where we used to be overwhelmed, listening to all the guest faculties and all the lectures and learning and everything. And you would be really surprised if I share one of my experiences. Way back, I think about 20 years back, there was one such guest lecture which was organized by my college back in those days, and it was about stock markets. And I even remember the name of the shares that my guest faculty had told us at that point in time. So friends, my effort will be that if you people, out of so many of you, even a few of you, if you can learn something good today and apply it in your life, I'm sure, you know, those people who really apply it in your life are really going to be having a lot of money with them. So with that, on that note, we can actually begin the session. And just to have a little bit idea about the people who I'm interacting with and the content that I'm going to deliver today, let me tell you one thing, that let's make this more interactive. It'll be more fun. एक लेक्चर जैसा नहीं लगना चाहिए, ठीक है? थोड़ा मजा करते हैं, थोड़ा इंटरेक्ट करते हैं. यू गाइज आर ओके इफ आई यूज बोथ द लैंग्वेजेस, इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी? परफेक्ट. ओके, एंड वी विल मेक इट इंटरेक्टिव. आई विल आस्क यू सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस एंड यू गाइज विल आंसर. और इफ यू पीपल हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस, वी विल टेक इट एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन, सो दैट यू नो आई कैन रियली आंसर इट इन अ मच बेटर वे. और हमारा जो एक फ्लो है वो ब्रेक ना हो. Now guys, how many of you are movie buffs? All of them? All of you, right? Movies to sabko pasand hai na? Okay, so I'm taking it as a yes, because I'm going to give you a lot of movie references. So, you know, okay, how many of you like numbers? Numbers, how many of you like numbers? Okay, how many of you hate numbers? Yeah, honestly, yeah, raise hands. How many of you hate numbers? Okay. Again, I'm asking, how many of you love numbers? Okay, हाँ. अब like से ज़्यादा love की बात आए तो बहुत hands raise हुए. So it's really good. So, you know, even during my college days, I used to find a lot of people who would say that, you know, maths पसंद नहीं है, ठीक है, करना पड़ रहा है, कर रहे हैं, and all that stuff. You know, so, and हमेशा financial management is associated with numbers. So I would just try to simplify concepts and really try and see to it that, you know, you people understand as much as possible. And you will be really surprised, financial concepts actually is all about using your common sense and nothing else. It's really not at all complicated. All these channels, CNBC or itna bada bada Economic Times, and you know, all of this, if you simply apply common sense, you all can actually make your wealth, you know, when you start earning and, you know, when you start saving and investing and all, you can actually make your wealth grow very easily. So, hamara jo hum session aaj yahan pe karenge, there will be certain things which you would already know, okay? So, there will be certain things which will be new. So, there will be learning, there will be relearning, and there will also be unlearning. So, there might be certain things which you already know, and you would kind of, I'll try and make the concepts better, because I thought that since you all are first year students, it's better that I, you know, take it little from the beginning, about little bit of economic concepts which I feel are basics to understand this big world of financial literacy and financial investments and all that. Yeah. So we move on. So this is going to be the outline of our talk. सेविंग्स इन्वेस्टिंग प्रिटी कॉमन सेंस राइट. आई मीन सेविंग्स तो करना ही चाहिए, इसमें कोई दो राय नहीं है. बट क्यों इतना ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट है, दैट ऑल्सो वील टेक इट फॉरवर्ड फ्रॉम देयर एंड आई वील वील टॉक अ लिटिल बिट मोर ऑन सेविंग्स एंड ऑल दैट. देन ऑफकोर्स सेविंग्स अलोन इज नॉट इनफ, वील टॉक अबाउट इन्वेस्टिंग, वील टॉक अबाउट सर्टन इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी, इन्फ्लेशन एंड कंपाउंडिंग. We understand a little bit about risk tolerance, about asset allocation, types of investments, insurance, financial freedom. You can read it for yourself. Again, jargons hai, bahut zyada tension lene ki zarurat nahi hai. All of this is very easy. Just, you know, let's just be with. point that I want to make here is that dreams are the basic thing. All of us have dreams, and nowadays, like, you know, I know many of you would be dreaming of starting your own company. Many of you would be dreaming of migrating to another country. Many of you would be dreaming a lot of things. The idea over here is कि हर एक ड्रीम्स के लिए पैसा लगता है, ठीक है? And if the planning of investments is done properly, then it is possible to meet all your dreams absolutely properly without any hassles, with actually peace of mind. It really doesn't matter कि हम, like, you know, I always tell this to my clients also कि wealthy होने के लिए ओके पैसा होना, बहुत ज्यादा पैसा होना जरूरी नहीं है. ओके दैट्स द आयरनी ऑफ द होल थिंग, दैट लोग वही समझते हैं कि अच्छा, यू नो व्हाट, बिकॉज दिस फैमिली इज वेल्दी, ही हैज मनी और ही इज रिच बिकॉज दिस फैमिली इज वेल्दी, और शी इज एबल टू डू दिस बिकॉज उसके पास तो बैकअप है. यू नो ऑल ऑफ दीज काइंड ऑफ लाइक यू नो डायलॉग्स एंड दीज काइंड ऑफ myths, I would say, we keep hearing in our day-to-day life. So today I'm going to show you some simple steps to actually tell you that it is not just about having money that will make you rich. Okay? It is all about having whatever little you have, whatever you are making as salary or income or whatever, after a period of time, after you people graduate and all that, whatever you are making, from that itself, आपके सारे ड्रीम्स पे टिक मार कर सकते हैं. ओके सो वी विल एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ हाउ इट इज डन. सो नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स टू लर्न. अभी जो मैंने बताया, ठीक है, उसके लिए हमें कुछ कॉन्सेप्ट्स दिमाग में क्लियर कर लेना बिल्कुल जरूरी है. सो फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी, वॉट एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट टूडे, एंड आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल टू जीएसएससी दैट यू नो दे इंट्रोड्यूस दिस कॉन्सेप्ट एंड दिस थिंग pretty early on, because it is a life skill. ये जो है, ये सारे concepts समझ के हम एक life skill आपको देना चाहते हैं, so that you people are empowered enough to make your money decisions in a much better way. So the first thing that we learn is marginal utility theory of money. Okay? How many of you are science students and how many of you have done taking commerce in 12th? Most are science students. Say yes or no. कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स कितने हैं? जस्ट गिव अ शाउट. अच्छा, ये पूरी गई कॉमर्स है. ओके सो मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी थ्योरी सबको पता है, सीखा तो है, राइट? बेसिक्स यहाँ पे. ओके कॉमन सेंस सोचते हैं. ओके okay, let me explain the concept first. Okay, so we have a video on marginal utility, but I'll explain it because I always feel that, you know, college में लोग lectures सुन के और graphs और numbers देखते के बहुत bored हो जाते हैं, and it's always better to learn it from an audio video, and that's why we have another video simply to explain you marginal utility theory of money. Okay, basically what it says is that economics का ये जो funda है, ये जो concept है, वो ये कहना चाहता है कि as and when we keep on consuming something one after the other, the inherent satisfaction or utility which is derived from that particular object जो हम consume कर रहे हैं या ले रहे हैं या खा रहे हैं, that particular utility actually goes diminishing. It's like we all of us would remember our first watch, okay? Then the second watch, then the third watch. So by the time we are buying the third watch, na, वो excitement थोड़ा सा कम हो जाता है. Simple, बहुत भूख लगी है, mango खानी है. Okay, we eat the first mango, we are like wow. The second mango we relish it. Third mango and we are like पेट भर गया. So हुआ क्या है यहाँ पे? What is the funda to understand that the utility of the consumption actually is going down. Okay, as we keep on progressing in life, something very similar. You know, it is, you know, all the things that you keep buying, because you know buying तो हमारा चालू ही रहने वाला है. We want to buy one bag, the another bag after couple of years, you know, all of these things. So जब हमारा जो इंडियन ethos है, our Indian ethos was always about saving money. Okay? Why? Because you know, consumption हम पहले हमेशा limited रखते थे कि भाई जितना पैसा है हम उतना ही consumption करते हैं. But in today's world, what has happened is, how many of you have Google phones, Android phones? Majority, I'm sure. उसमें सबसे उसमें एक चीज आती है, which is Google Ads. ठीक है, it keeps on prompting you to buy, buy, buy and buy. Right? जो हमने कुछ सर्च किया होगा ना, वो भी Google Ads में आता रहता है. So what are these companies trying to do? They are trying to change your brain into buying things. And what is it that we have to remember as we grow up in life? That marginal utility of things are going to reduce. Okay? So it's you know, we have to understand this concept ki cheezon ka mol kam hota jata hai as we go on. So this is basically marginal utility theory of money. What I will do is we'll skip this video and we will take this video in the end. But I believe all of you understood the concept. Right, because we've already begun 15 minutes late and I have like you know a time constraint of imparting you all the concepts. Okay, can we move to the next slide? Okay, so what happens is that marginal utility to maine samjha hai ki paise ka jo cheez hai uska mol kam hota jata hai. Dusri baat jo ho kya raha hai, dusri baat jo ho ye raha hai, can we go back to the equation slide? दूसरी बात जो हो ये रहा है दैट द प्राइसेस ऑफ दोस थिंग्स आर एक्चुअली गोइंग अप. ओके, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इन्फ्लेशन. ऑल ऑफ अस नो अबाउट इन्फ्लेशन, भाव वधारो, महंगाई, ऑल ऑफ दोस थिंग्स. सो एक चीज समझो कि जो जो चीज हम लेना चाहते हैं एक के बाद एक के बाद एक के बाद एक, उसका वैल्यू कम हो रहा है लेकिन भाव तो हर बार बढ़ रहा है. सो द फर्स्ट वॉच वी कंज्यूम, हम लोग जो पहला वॉच खरीदते हैं, okay, that is going to let's say cost whatever 2,000-3,000 rupees. लेकिन हम जो दूसरा वॉच खरीदते हैं ना, वो हमेशा पहले वाले से महंगा रहता है. Phones also, all these marketing companies are trying to do that only, right? पहला फोन लिया हम लोग सब नोकिया का छोटा, I don't know, you guys don't even remember, but the first Nokia phone that I got was this one, 1200 rupees का. Okay, and then today it's all about Android smartphones and you know limit है, 1,00,000 rupees का, 1,100 rupees से लेके 1,00,000 rupees तक के phones मिलते हैं. Right, and always your next purchase, please understand the utility is going to be less, but the price is going to be more. So so that is basically the hidden enemy of our wealth. So humko sabse important ye cheez samajhni hai that there is something which is called as inflation. Okay, inflation basically it sinks your purchasing power, and again the same thing, you know. 1 liter of petrol, 1 liter of milk, how it has kind of increased. So there is this concept of CAGR, एक चीज लिखी है हमने, which is called as basically compounded annual growth rate. Okay, so the 1 liter of petrol, and now how much is it? ये तो 2018 तक का data है. 2021 how much is 1 liter of petrol? 94. So imagine 74 से 94 हो गया. 18 से 2021 में, ठीक है? So if we actually see CAGR or compounded annual growth rate, it's around 7.5%. Okay, so whenever like you know I'm doing this lecture or you know when kids come to me for training and all that, we actually make them do a project. Then you know when you were born, what was the age of, what was the cost of 1 bar of chocolate, and you know when you were 15 or 16. You know, 16th birthday, 18th birthday, and then today, how one simple 100 grams bar of chocolate, how the prices have gone up, right? So, simple thing is that the saving we do will just not be enough. Okay, it has to be basically we have to invest it properly. In save to karna compulsory hai, because if we just don't do savings, we'll not be able to meet any of our future needs. There was a slide on saving, but it's pretty simple. We all know it by common sense that saving we have to do because you know we have to save for emergencies, we have to save for our goals and dreams, and we have to save because we want to increase our wealth. But sirf saving se kaam nahi chalega, we have to also do invest it properly in such a way that we are able to counter inflation. Inflation se zyada humko returns milne chahiye. This was my only a point that I wanted to drive.
next slide. Okay. Now, inflation क्या आपके और मेरे हाथ में है? Do we decide petrol prices? No, right? So what do we have to do? We just have to, like you know, either कम petrol भराओ, अगर समझो हम सिर्फ save कर रहे हैं और पैसा invest नहीं कर रहे हैं, तो what are the options that we have? We don't have anything in our hands, right? We don't have petrol in our hands. We don't have petrol prices. We don't have real estate prices. We don't have any prices in our hands. We only have to respond to the situation which is there in life, right? So we have to find out कि कैसे करें. Okay, so we have to devise our own method, our own planning that we are able to grow more than the petrol prices are growing. Simple, right? If I मुझे saving भी अगर future में करना है तो मुझे जो है मुझे inflation से ज़्यादा तो मुझे मेरा पैसा grow करना ही पड़ेगा, right? So कैसे करें? Okay, how do we do that? Basically, we have to understand the power of compounding. Okay. Which is basically nothing but it's called as the eighth wonder of the world. Now compound interest सबने पढ़ा है ना, eighth standard. Compound interest, everyone knows, right? So basically, now let us understand that better. Okay, this is an interesting video, and I really want you guys to see this.
उसकी माली हालत इतनी खराब हुई कि घर में खाने के लाले पड़ गए. इसी कारण उसने महल में जाकर राजा से मदद मांगने का फैसला किया. राजा के बुलाए जाने पर उसने अपनी कविताएं पढ़नी शुरू कर दी. राजा बहुत प्रसन्न हुआ और उसने कवि से अपना इनाम मांगने के लिए कहा. कवि ने मोहरों से सजे शतरंज की ओर इशारा करते हुए कहा, महाराज अगर आप पहले खाने में चावल का एक दाना रखें और हर खाने के लिए उसे दुगना करते जाएं, तो मैं समझूंगा मुझे मेरा इनाम मिल गया.
बस इतना ही?
राजा ने पूछा.
सिर्फ चावल का एक दाना और सोना नहीं?
जी हाँ महाराज.
तो फिर ऐसा ही हो.
दरबारियों ने चावल के दाने रखने शुरू कर दिए. पहले खाने में एक, दूसरे में दो, तीसरे में चार, चौथे में आठ, इस तरह वो रखते गए. जब दसवें खाने में चावल रखने की बारी आई तो उन्हें चावल के 512 दाने रखने पड़े. बीसवें खाने तक संख्या बढ़कर 5,24,288 हो गई. आधे हिस्से तक आते आते 32वें खाने में चावल के दानों की गिनती 214,74,83,648 हो गई. जल्द ही गिनती अरबों खरबों में पड़ गई. आखिरकार अभागे राजा को अपना पूरा राजपाट उस चतुर कवि के हाथों सौंपना पड़ा और इसकी शुरुआत चावल के सिर्फ एक दाने से हुई थी. कहानी की सीख, चक्रवृद्धि की ताकत को कम नहीं आंकना चाहिए.
Important concepts: inflation, the way it is rising. The only way to counter that inflation is use this power of compounding to our advantage. It is a mathematical law. It is a fundamental. There is no rocket science. It is, as I have explained, that you know it can be. So, आप पता चला कि वो कवि था और कैसे वाला नहीं था, right? He had nothing, okay, and he could basically tell trick that king. So I think with that video, all of you know how important is power of compounding and how we are going to use it. So now let us plan our financial future in such a way that all our dreams and goals are met. Okay? So let's begin. The first step is saving, of course, that you know how we'll start, at what years and all that. So working years and retirement age. So retirement is a very boring word. I don't like it. What I like really is the word which is called as financial freedom. How many of you want to set up your own company? How many of you want to, like, you know, have your own startups and stuff like that? Dream, yeah, dream karne mein to kuch nahi jata hai. Okay, really, I mean, you know, the way India is growing and all that, we all should have lot many people, you know, really dreaming about having their own ideas, starting their own companies and all that. And for that, basically, the word that I usually tell to everyone is basically financial freedom. Okay? The financial freedom basically means that हमारे पास उतना पैसा इकट्ठा हो जाए that particular money is able to take care of our day-to-day needs and then we can focus on what we love to do. It can be traveling, it can be a passion for writing, it can be having your own startup, it can be a lot of things. And believe me, if you start as soon as you get your first salary, वो चावल का एक दाना था, right? As soon as you get your first salary, of course, first the money has to, you know, basically go to your parents, okay, in terms of as a gratitude. But even from that first salary, even if you start with 100 rupees or with 500 rupees, first, अगर वो ही दिन से शुरू किया, then you know you will actually see that in the next 10 or 15 years you will have enough amount of wealth to actually do whatever you people want to do, okay? So anyways, let's move ahead. So the next slide, okay. So power of compounding, it's a fantastic thing. Thoda hum isme numbers dekh lete hain. Boring cheez, concept aap logo ko samajh mein aa gaya hai. So agar humne, it just says ki 8%, 10%, 12%, 15%. You know, agar humne zyada rate of return mein invest kiya, so 1 lakh has grown in 30 years to 66 lakhs. If 1 lakh has become 66 lakhs in 30 years, if it has just grown at 15%. Anyways, these are numbers. Ye har time change hota rehta hai. What is important to understand is, start even if it is 100 rupees or 500 rupees, usko save karo aur usko invest karo at the best possible rate of interest. Now again the next. Okay, now what exactly is investing? Is buying an asset that you think will grow in value or generate income for you. So there are two things. Asset cheez kya hoti hai? Investing hota kya hai? That you know whatever you save karne ke baad humne kuch bhi invest kiya. Okay? If that particular thing is going to grow in value, okay? Or in the future it is going to give you income. Okay, now tell me one thing. Buying a car. Car bhi to ek asset hai. Okay? Buying a car, is it investment?
No.
It's consumption, right? Buying a phone?
No.
Consumption. Okay, then buying a bike. All of you have your own bikes? Okay. So here we give you some examples to show you that what is, you know, how we can differentiate between, yeah, how we can basically differentiate between consumption and investment. एक बहुत सुपर एग्जांपल है। How many of you have ये आयशन मोटर्स का व्हाट इस डी ब्रांड ऑफ़ डी बाइक? Enfield, Royal Enfield किसी के पास है? बहुत सारे होंगे, right? Royal Enfield, okay? Royal Enfield, what will be the cost of the bike? तुम लोगों को पता है यार, मुझे भी पता है। 2 lakhs, awesome. अभी मेरे ज़माने की बात करते हैं। Okay, 20 years ago, investing in Royal Enfield bike versus uski jo company ye particular bike banati hai, uska share, okay, bazaar mein traded hai, milta hai. Okay, it's the same company. Okay, 2001 mein Royal Enfield bike was costing 55,000 rupees. Okay, agar so let's take an example that there are two people, A and B. Okay, now A ने पापा ने बोला कि यार तूने ग्रेजुएट हो गया तू यू नो आई एम सो प्राउड ऑफ यू एंड ऑल दैट ओके यू नो बाय व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू बाय Then the guy said that okay, fantastic, I'm going to buy a Royal Enfield bike, which is going to cost 55,000 rupees. They said, okay, diya. Okay, there is another person who says ki, yaar, 55,000 rupees, chodo na my, like, you know, let me buy a second hand bike, you know, I have some saving. 10-15,000 ki, woh zamane mein 10-15,000 ki second hand bike mil jata tha. Theek hai, good one. I'm not saying that, you know, you have to compromise on consumption. But somewhere, we all of us have to rationalize consumption. Kitna farq padta hai, woh dekh lo. 3,000 उसी 55,000 से रुपीस से 3,000 शेयर आते थे आयशा मोटर्स के विच वॉज ओनली 18 रुपीज एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम ओके नाउ ईयर 2020 में यू कैन गेस हाउ मच अ 20 ईयर अभी 20 साल हुए बाइक को उसको तो रद्दी के भाव में बेचना पड़ेगा ठीक है बट ये जो हमने 55,000 रुपीज जो हमने आयशा मोटर का स्टॉक खरीद के छोड़ दिया था दैट इज वर्थ 7.5 crores Imagine 55,000 rupees invested for 20 years. Even Aisha Motaka stock, which has grown multiple times, you can today actually buy a. What is the cost of Rolls Royce car? Anybody who's into cars? 5 crores? Uske baad bhi paisa bachta. Aaj Rolls Royce aa jati. Theek hai? So, my point over here is that somewhere. All of us need to rationalize consumption. Okay? So, okay, we all could have done one more thing. Hero Honda ka bike mein le sakte thi. Back in the year 2000. Theek hai? Or 2001, whatever. Out of 55,000 rupees, let's say I told my father that okay, I'll buy a bike which is costing 20-25,000 rupees. Okay? Good looking, everything. Even Hero, pata nahi bahut sare brands the wo time ke liye. Half the cost and remaining
Sometimes if there are too many choices. And by the way, friends,
ये हर एक एसेट क्लास के बारे में वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक लिटिल बिट ऑफ एडिशनल नॉलेज आई विल इंपार्ट टू यू कि किसको कहां इन्वेस्ट करना चाहिए, कितना अमाउंट कैसे, ठीक है, सब समझते हैं. ओके, सो देयर आर टू मेनी चॉइसेस. ओके, नाउ दिस इज समथिंग अगेन वेरी बेसिक, राइट? हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एसेट क्लासेस आर देयर? फिजिकल एसेट, फाइनेंशियल एसेट, और अभी यहां पे एक और एसेट क्लास जुड़ जाएगा व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज डिजिटल एसेट which is nothing but crypto. We will talk a little bit more. Whatever I understand, it is pretty nascent field as of now, but whatever I understand, I can, you know, definitely share my knowledge. So physical assets, real estate, gold, and then financial assets, maybe have equity and fixed income. However, there is a thing that you all need to know, that there is something which is called as financialization of fixed assets. Yani ab har ek cheez paper ke form mein milti hai. गोल्ड तो यू कैन हैव, बेसिकली फिजिकल गोल्ड लेने की जरूरत नहीं है. गोल्ड तुमको एक शेयर ब्रोकर ने दिला के देगा, इट्स कॉल्ड गोल्ड एक्सचेंज ट्रेडेड फंड, ETF. ओके, वी कम टू दैट. सो इवन रियल एस्टेट, इमेजिन रियल एस्टेट को हम लोग एक डॉक्यूमेंट के फॉर्म में, एक पेपर के फॉर्म में विद ऑल द रेगुलेशंस भी आपको ऑफर कर सकते हैं. इट इज कॉल्ड एज रियल एस्टेट इन्वेस्टमेंट ट्रस्ट, REITs. ये सब आप आगे whoever is specializing in finance will understand. And anyways, at this stage maybe we don't need to go to all that. We can stick to financial asset में हम लोग आज के इस session में we will concentrate on equity and fixed income. Okay? Fixed income as the name suggests that it is fixed return. Right? Can I have some examples of fixed return? यहाँ से मुझे किसी ने पोस्ट और बैंक एफडी बोला था. और कुछ पता है तुम लोगों को? PPF, yes, then EPF, then what are the different options जहाँ पे fixed returns मिलते हैं? या एफडी, हाँ, yes, bonds, very good. Science वाले यार थोड़ा सा और आंसर करो. कॉमर्स वालों को तो सब आता है, थोड़ा बहुत आता है, कॉन्सेप्ट आता है. ओके, सो फिक्स्ड रिटर्न, कॉमन सेंस, जिसमें एक फिक्स्ड रिटर्न मिलता है, ठीक है, जिसमें ऑटोमेटिकली फिक्स्ड रिटर्न मिलता है, तो मतलब क्या हुआ, रिस्क कम है, समझ में आ गया, क्योंकि वो फिक्स्ड रिटर्न मिलता है इसमें, ठीक है. उसका टेन्योर भी फिक्स्ड होता है, 5 years, 10 years, 3 years, 4 years, व्हाटएवर इट इज, राइट. रिस्क कम होता है, वोलेटिलिटी जैसी कोई चीज होती नहीं, क्योंकि वो रिटर्न मिलते ही जाता है. However, the thing is that, can you go to the previous slide? One is risk of your principal, right? हमने जितना मूडी इन्वेस्ट किया है, जितना हमने कैपिटल इन्वेस्ट किया है, वो भी कभी कभी कम हो सकता है. Secondly, risk कभी कभी होता है returns के ऊपर भी, right? For example, कि इसमें से 5% मिलेगा, 6% मिलेगा, जितना भी percent मिलेगा, that is also not fixed. और वो भी ऊपर नीचे हो सकता है. तो रिस्क होता है कैपिटल पे और रिटर्न्स पे, ठीक है. सो रिस्क इज देयर. नाउ देयर इज अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट अबाउट रिस्क, दैट रिस्क कैन नेवर बी एलिमिनेटेड. रिस्क ऐसी चीज है जो आप कभी भी जीरो नहीं कर सकते हो, उसको मिटिगेट कर सकते हो, उसको डाइवर्सिफाई कर सकते हो, ठीक है. सी, वी ऑल आर लिविंग हियर राइट नाउ, वी, व्हाट इज द, ऑल ऑफ यू, आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू विल बी वैक्सीनेटेड, I'm sure compulsory in the college. Still, are we sure कि हमको दोबारा COVID नहीं होगा? No, right? Biggest example. Risk हमने mitigate किया है through vaccination, but we have not eliminated the risk, right? So something similar, but we have learned to live with risk, coexist with it, and still make a peaceful living out of it. That's exactly the thing which we have to do over here also in investments. ओके, अब वो देखते हैं कैसे. नाउ फर्स्ट एंड द फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज वी हैव टू बेसिकली इन्वेस्टमेंट्स के लिए हमको एक एसेट एलोकेशन, ओके, सो या, सो द थिंग इज दैट जब कभी भी हम इन्वेस्टमेंट्स के बारे में शुरू करते हैं, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग विच इज एसेट एलोकेशन प्रोसेस. फाइनेंशियल एसेट क्या होता है, कॉमर्स पीपल नो, बट इन टर्म्स ऑफ See, whatever you give the money and then whatever you acquire is called as an asset, right? So now, where we have to do the investment, usme sabse pehle we have to follow an asset allocation process. Okay? Usme sabse pehla point hai that you have to define goals and time horizon. See, to all the crypto people who have invested in crypto, how many of you are there who have invested in crypto? Quite a bit. Okay. Have you understood crypto properly? You've understood crypto properly. Right. Then I think I can also learn a little bit from you. Crypto ka risk, return, sab kuch dekha hai. Theek hai? Achha, crypto mein humne invest kyun kiya? Returns ke liye. ठीक है. और दूसरा हमने इसके लिए भी इन्वेस्ट किया क्योंकि मेरे फ्रेंड ने इन्वेस्ट किया. ठीक है, बाजार में चल रहा है अरे उसको बहुत अच्छे रिटर्न्स मिले हैं सो लेट मी आल्सो ट्राई. ठीक है, ये होता है, दिस हैपेंस. समथिंग वेरी सिमिलर, इट्स नॉट ओनली विद यू पीपल, इट हैपेंस टुडे. इवन व्हेन आई गेट अ क्लाइंट टू इन्वेस्ट, ही विल फर्स्ट टेल मी दैट बजार में आ बहुत सरस चाले छे, म्यूचुअल फंड्स करीने सांभळ्यु छे बहुत सरस छे, આપણે ઇન્વેસ્ટ કરવું છે. ઇટ્સ લાઈક પીપલ વિલ ઓલવેઝ લાઈક યુ નો સે ધેટ ઓકે બીકોઝ ધ સ્ટોક માર્કેટ્સ આર ડુઇંગ વેલ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ઇન્વેસ્ટ ઇન ઇક્વિટી, બટ બીકોઝ ધીસ ઇઝ ડુઇંગ વેલ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ઇન્વેસ્ટ હિયર. એક્ચ્યુઅલી ધેટ ઇઝ ધ એબ્સોલ્યુટલી રોંગ મેથડ ઓફ ઇન્વેસ્ટમેન્ટ. વોટ યુ બેસિકલી હેવ ટુ ડુ ઇઝ સ્ટાર્ટ વિથ ડિફાઇનિંગ યોર ઓન ગોલ્સ. હમને ડ્રીમ્સ સે શરૂ કિયા હૈ યે સેશન, રાઈટ? ડ્રીમ્સ વિલ બેસિકલી કલ્યુલેટ ઇન ટુ ગોલ્સ. કરો કે ધીસ ઇઝ વોટ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ડુ એન્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ ધ રીઝન આઈ એમ ઇન્વેસ્ટિંગ, એન્ડ ઇઝ યોર ફર્સ્ટ મની, second salary, third paycheck, whatever it is, right? So first of all, you invest your goals, define your goals, and then very importantly, you have to define your time horizon. Okay, so defining the time horizon may whether you want to invest for long term or whether you want to invest for short term. Okay, yani for example, if you are taking a job experience of let's say 1 year, okay, and you have the plans of going abroad, right? Going abroad and, you know, pursuing your higher education. And you are taking job experience only for 1 year. So how much, so whatever you will earn, you will predominantly want to use for your higher education, if that is the goal, right? Then how much is your investment horizon? Aapka pehla salary aaya, okay? How much is your investment horizon? How much is your investment horizon if you are just going to do the job for 1 year? It's 1 year, right? Ek saal 12 mahino mein kaam karunga, baad mein mujhe abroad jana hai. Okay, this is, and it can also mean that, okay, you know, I don't know main kab jaunga, but yes, I have that goal. So then it's a different thought process, right? So the first thing is that yes, we have to define our time horizon, short term and long term. Short term is typically between anything which is 1 day of investment to, it can be basically 3 years, 4 years. Anything which is more than 5 years to 7 years is considered long term, and anything less than that is considered short term. Okay? उसके बाद we have to identify an asset mix कि भाई कितना पैसा है जो किसमें जाना चाहिए. Short term है तो we have very limited options, but अगर long term investment है then we have more options to invest. Okay? Then we also have to assess our own risk tolerance. Okay, how many of you are comfortable if your money becomes zero in crypto? Okay, how many of you are comfortable if Ajinomoto's would have become zero? Paisa dal ke chhod diya, acha theek hai, wo zero ho jayega, tu bhi chalega. How many of you are there? At this age, maybe none, because father would have given us some money, parents ka paisa hoga. We don't want to lose, right? How many of you are okay to lose money? Can I have hand raises? How many of you are okay to lose money? None. Okay, one, two. ठीक है. So basically my point here that I want to drive is that maybe some portion of money, if you lose, it's okay. हमारा risk tolerance, for lesser amount of money, we have a higher risk tolerance. Okay? So then create a target portfolio and then specific investment को select करो और उसको review करो. So basically it's a 3-step process. First identify your goals and then identify where you want to invest and then monitor it. And then keep on doing this cycle again every year. That is the simple long story short. Can you go to long term short term? Okay. So now goals for this is exactly what I explained earlier. So
So if our goals is 5 to 7 years plus, okay, then we can definitely invest into equity shares, equity based mutual funds, ULIPs of insurance companies, real estate, land, gold. ये सब लॉन्ग टर्म में आएगा. ओके, इक्विटी शेयर्स आइडियली स्पीकिंग वी कैन नॉट इन्वेस्ट इफ अवर टाइम होराइजन इज लेस देन 5 years. ओके, नाउ कमिंग बैक टू दिस थिंग, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो और ओके हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट इक्विटी. ओके, लेट मी आस्क यू, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू डोंट नो व्हाट इज इक्विटी मार्केट, एस्पेशली दिस एनालिस्ट स्पीकर. ओके 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 ओके, सो let's take it forward from there on in terms of what exactly is equity market or share market. Movies dekhe na, ye which was the latest show that Harshad Mehta, scandal dekha? How many of you saw? Most of you. Scary na, very scary, right? In terms of ki, oh my god, this looks like a place wherein, you know, if you put money kuch haath mein nahi aane wala hai. Okay, however it is not so. Let me explain, okay, what exactly is equity markets or what exactly is share market or kaise yahan pe paise bante hain. So there is one thing, the word share we all understand, right? Share is like share, right? So there is something which is called as share is like, you know, I will share with you, you know, all that. So basically, okay, how many of you have business families? Business kaise kitne log hai? So, जिसके भी पेरेंट्स बिजनेस करते हैं उसमें यह होता है कि जब बिजनेस में प्रॉफिट होता है तो दैट प्रॉफिट्स बेसिकली रिमेन्स ओनली विद द ओनर ऑफ द बिजनेस. ओके, नाउ तो आपके पापा ने जो भी सोचा, व्हाटएवर स्किल ही यूज्ड एंड एवरीथिंग ही लर्नड एंड ही अप्लाइड एंड यू नो उन्होंने ट्रेडिंग किया या यू नो व्हिचएवर फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस किया, राइट, उस उनके हार्ड अर्नड एफर्ट्स के बाद उनको वो पैसा मिला, सो ही विल कीप इट विद हिमसेल्फ. ओके, और मे बी रिटर्न इट टू द बैंक, व्हाटएवर वाज ओव्ड टू द बैंक एंड ऑल दैट. नाउ आई गिव यू अनदर एग्जांपल, अज्यूमिंग इट इज लेट्स से अ मुकेश अंबानी. ओके, मुकेश अंबानी एज इट इज हैव टन्स ऑफ मनी एंड ही इज एनी विच इज लाइक यू नो पुटिंग हिज ब्रेन्स एंड एवरीथिंग एंड यू नो रनिंग अ जियो प्लेटफॉर्म एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट स्टफ. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट इफ आई एम अ मेन इन्वेस्टर हूं, ओके, मैं सोचती हूँ कि यार देखो ये मुकेश बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, आई विश आई एम एबल टू डू समथिंग लाइक हिम. सो आई कॉल अप मुकेश अंबानी, ओके, दैट सर यू नो मेरे को भी आपके इन्वेस्टमेंट आई मीन आपका बिजनेस मेरे को बहुत पसंद आ रहा है, आपको बहुत पैसा कमा रहे हो. सो मुकेश अंबानी मुझे बोलता है कि यार एक काम कर, तेरे को यू नो आई गिव यू शेयर ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स, तेरे पास जितना पैसा है ना लगा ले. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज that I give money to Mukesh Ambani so that I am able to benefit out of his company which is so huge, jo main akele life mein kabhi nahi kar sakti, theek hai. But does that mean ki main Mukesh Ambani jitne paise nahi kama sakti? No, that's not the answer. The thing is that we can earn good money, okay, even by investing in somebody else's business. Aur wo jo zariya hai of investing in somebody else's business is through the share market. And as the name suggests, share, what is Mukesh Ambani going to give me? Share of his profits. Okay? And that's exactly share market. Aap samajh mein aaya? Kitno ko abhi bhi nahi samajh mein aaya? Easy? Concept? Share kya? Concept? Profits. Simple. Okay? So, isi tarah se, Facebook. Okay? Abhi isse kya dimag lagaya bande mein? You know, created something which is called as Facebook. Today, you won't believe I can invest into the shares of a Facebook company right here, sitting in front of you in India. It is absolutely possible. Okay. Now, again, something similar. So the thing is, understand one thing: that share market is a such a place. Okay, जहाँ पे बहुत सारे risks हैं. There are people like what you saw in scandal. Okay, there are people like when you read the newspapers, you have 5 names which are bad. But if you go to the startup page, if you go to the थोड़ा और पढ़ोगे तो उसमें there are another 10 names which are extremely good, like the Tatas, the Birlas. They all, this is exactly the way of value creation. उन्होंने हम सबको value दिया, इसके लिए उन्होंने पैसा कमाया.
See, without value, nothing can happen in this world. You will never call me again, okay, for the guest lecture, if I am not able to deliver value to you, right? So now, understand the same thing in the stock markets. So, usko dekhne ke kai saare tareeke hain. Okay, main aisa nahi bol rahi hu ki wahan pe risk nahi hai. There are absolutely enough and more number of bad people. Bad businesses bhi honge hi na. Maine Mukesh Ambani ko paisa diya, Mukesh Ambani chhod nikla to, mera to waisa gaya boss. It was my hard money, right? वैसे भी लोग हैं और अच्छे भी लोग हैं, you know, who actually create value. So which basically means that we should have the ability to basically find out value creating good businesses. समझ में आ गया? Right? Common sense stuff. Okay, now we can move on in terms of that shares. Now what happens is that you and me, okay? अभी उस चीज को समझने के लिए कि ये बिजनेस अच्छा है कि नहीं, उसके लिए क्या करना पड़ेगा, राइट? सो वी कैन नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक इज प्रीटी बिग इन डिटेल, बट अगेन आई विल माय टारगेट इज टू एक्चुअली डिलीवर कॉन्सेप्ट्स टू यू इज दैट यू नो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि ये आदमी लाइक यू नो व्हाट इज उसके बैलेंस शीट कैसी है, लाइक हाउ आर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स कैसे, वो हमको पढ़ना आना चाहिए. वी नीड लाइक यू नो वी कैन नो हाउ द सेल्स आर हैपनिंग, उसका बिजनेस क्या है, ये वो सब. नाउ उस तरह का स्किल सब में तो नहीं होगा, राइट? यू एंड मी विल नॉट हैव दैट स्किल. सो देन व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल गो टू द एक्सपर्ट्स. ओके, सो दोज एक्सपर्ट्स आर नथिंग बट म्यूचुअल फंड मैनेजर्स हु आइडेंटिफाई दीज स्टॉक्स एंड शेयर्स एंड इन्वेस्ट इन देम. ठीक है, सो नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ सो इक्विटी शेयर्स आर एक्सप्लेन्ड. ओके, equity based mutual funds is the same thing. उसमें एक portfolio रहता है, एक fund manager रहता है, ठीक है? And then there are some other products that I have written. It's okay, we need not go in detail. And then now it comes to कि चलो short term goals और medium term goals है, उसके लिए हम FDs और bonds वगैरह में invest कर सकते हैं जहाँ के safe return मिलना चाहिए. सिर्फ risk हमेशा long term के लिए ही लेना चाहिए. शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए इट हैज टू बी फिक्स डिपॉजिट बॉन्ड्स. अगर हमको नेक्स्ट ईयर जाना है अब्रॉड या व्हाटएवर, सो देन दैट मनी हैज टू बी इन बॉन्ड्स, फिक्स डिपॉजिट वगैरह. इफ वी इन्वेस्ट विद दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड लॉजिक, देन वी विल नेवर बी अफ्रेड इन लाइफ. वी विल नेवर हैव द अप्स एंड डाउन्स एंड ऑल दैट. ओके, वी लर्न टू मिटिगेट इट. ओके, नाउ लेट मी गो अहेड. ओके ओके, अभी जो इन्वेस्टमेंट्स जो होते हैं वो भी अगेन वी कैन क्लासिफाई. पहले तो गोल समझ लिया आप लोगों ने, लॉन्ग टर्म एंड शॉर्ट टर्म. एंड देन देयर आर अगेन टू काइंड्स ऑफ एसेट्स, इनकम एसेट्स एंड ग्रोथ एसेट्स. इन द सेंस कि जब हम इन्वेस्ट करते हैं तभी हमें वो भी ध्यान में रखना है. वी हैव टू हैव दैट थिंग इन माइंड दैट वे आई मीन व्हाट डू वी वांट फ्रॉम दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट. इज इट जस्ट अ कैपिटल ग्रो और वी नीड इनकम आउट ऑफ इट. Most of you people, because you will anyways be into jobs or new businesses and all that, you won't need income in your hands, right? Because income is always there. So what should be your goal? Basically, find out assets which should give you growth. Okay, growth assets. So again, it is mein shares aayega, gold, real estate, ye sab aayega. ठीक है, because इसमें हमको growth मिलता है. Gold लेके रखा उसमें से income मिलती है. How do we get income out of gold? When we sell, what we get is the gain. Okay, नफा मिलता है उसमें और अपने, so it is called as gain. Gold में पैसे रखिए और फिर उसमें से gold में से pension मिलता है? No. Gold में से salary मिलता है? Okay. एक इसमें एक there is a rider there, there is a gold bond जो कि आया है market में, जिसमें interest मिलता है. So it's a different thing, but anyway, so conceptually you all understood what is growth and income, right? Okay, now let's move on. Okay, now this is something extremely important, and it was an eye opener. It is an eye opener for many people that आपका portfolio, आपने जिसमें जिसमें invest किया है, crypto and stocks and you know all of those things, उसमें से what is the success, यानी portfolio में perform किसके लिए किया, उसका क्या reason हो सकता है? Some people say security selection, कोई बोलता है market timing,
ओके कोई बोलता है लाइक यू नो सम अदर थिंग्स बट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्चुअली इज एसेट एलोकेशन यानी माय पोर्टफोलियो हाउ इट परफॉर्म्स इज बेसिकली मोर बेस्ड कि मैंने कितना पैसा कहाँ इन्वेस्ट किया है इन द लॉन्ग टर्म इट डजंट रियली मैटर कि मैंने आई मीन कैन यू रियली इमेजिन दिस सिक्योरिटी सिलेक्शन इज ओनली 4.6% एंड मैंने आयशर मोटर्स नहीं लेके 2000 में कोई और शेयर भी लिया होता अच्छा वाला ओके तो भी मेरा रिटर्न उतना ही बनता साठ व्हाटएवर 3-4-5-3 crores or something 1 crore or 3 crores ओके देयर कैन बी लिटिल डिफरेंस आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट यू नो प्रोवाइडेड आई हैव सिलेक्टेड अ गुड कंपनी ओके इफ आई हैव सिलेक्टेड अ गुड कंपनी चाहे वो आयशर हो या इट कैन बी एनी अदर कंपनी लाइक स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया और एन HDFC बैंक ऑल ऑफ दीज के शेयर्स भी थे ही तभी then also my return would have been similar not same okay so it's not about identifying the best stock okay it is not even about identifying ki oh you know market niche tha kabhi le liya upar le liya no it is basically maine kitna paisa kahan pe lagaya aur kitne samay ke liye usko chhod diya laga ke that is more important okay so we move on okay so this we have understood I have already discussed this in terms of equity what kind of investment if they invest if the money is invested to own part share of a business is called equity and if the money is lent to business on interest it is called debt so for all the people equity we have understood it is share of profits what is debt ya bonds ya jo bhi bolte hain usme kya hota hai after the money is invested basically you only have to after we invest the money we only get the interest part yani isme share of profits nahi aata hai so banks jo hai banks unko jo paisa deti hai basically those are called as loans right so loans mein kya hota hai humko interest dena hota hai loan ka okay do we give our profits to the bank no right so now think of it from the another perspective mukesh ambani ko main do cheez de sakta hu मैंने उसको पैसा दिया है लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू इन्वेस्ट मनी विद मुकेश अंबानी ओके ही कैन टेल मी टू थिंग्स ओके डू यू वांट प्रॉफिट्स ऑफ माई बिजनेस देन यू वेट फॉर 5 years ओके द अदर थिंग ही कैन टेल मी आई कैन टेल हिम मेरी यार 5 साल किसे देखा हूँ नोज 5 years एंड ऑल नो आई वॉन्ट माई इंटरेस्ट एवरी ईयर ओके सो देन ही सेड ठीक है आई गिव यू 8% इंटरेस्ट एवरी ईयर बट देन विल आई गेट द शेयर ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स नो मेरे को मेरा आपका काम नहीं गया दैट्स इट मुकेश अंबानी से बाय बाय सो The thing is that, but he will always say, "Yeah, मेरा तो loss हो गया. I'm not able to give you the share of profits this year." So you know that equity has much high risk and high return. It will depend whether Mukesh Ambani makes profit or not that I get my share of profits. Okay? But the other thing is debt. Meaning I can always give a loan to Mukesh Ambani and just take interest. So that is the difference between equity and debt. And risk, return, and liquidity we have already discussed. Risk is high in equity and low in debt. So debt is nothing but bonds, debt, fixed deposit. ये सब भाई बहन same नहीं है but भाई बहन. तो समझ लो that concept. And liquidity is how easily you are able to get your money back out of that particular product. ठीक है? So which is very easy for comparatively for debt products, but may not be easy for equity. Okay? So now okay so now these are different goals and different kya kya hum products choose kar sakte in terms of investments so first is of course assess your needs and establish your goals whether you want to build a house or education or retirement stroke financial freedom whether you want to go for a vacation or whether you want to have an emergency fund so all of you all should you know as soon as you kind of basically get a life and get a salary and get a job or start your business and all that sabse pehle you should you know have an emergency fund set aside jo ki aap FD mein rakh sakte hain theek hai which can be you know emergency fund kabhi bhi equity mein ya crypto mein ya aise kahin pe nahi hona chahiye because wo emergency mein hai fir crypto ka bhav niche hoga to unko milega hi nahi wo paisa it cannot be into equity markets because again equity market can be up down whatever right so we cannot have it there also so emergency funds best to have it in a mutual fund which is a debt side mutual fund hota hai ya to fir it can be into bank FDs or whatever so that's the first thing that you have to keep it aside especially if you are living
away from your parents and you know you are in some other city or country or whatever. Then of course, let's say vacation. Okay, all of us love to take trips, right? And मैं तो सबसे पहले vacation के लिए plan करती हूँ. Okay, vacation typically every year हम लेते हैं. ठीक है. So even that kind of comes into the short term category because you know every year you want to keep some money aside and all. So we have to really think about that also. And then of course retirement. Okay, as I said earlier, I don't know if I like that word, but the thing is that you know, पहली सैलरी में कोई रिटायरमेंट के बारे में सोचेगा क्या? Never, right? But actually the funny part is that's why I am going to now remove this word from my presentation, from my next presentation onwards for sure. Nobody really thinks about retirement from the first salary. Okay. However, going back to the video that we saw, okay, of that rice ka dana, it is, and even the Aisha Motor slide. I mean, imagine my first salary. You know, I also like, you know, kind of got my first salary in 2001. I feel that I should have done that. You know, bought an Aisha Motor shares, I would have retired or I would have been financially free right now. Okay, even I made that mistake, and I don't want you people to make that mistake. Invest for your financial freedom from your first salary itself. Okay, and we have lot of reasons and lot of data to prove that to you. But even if it is one grain of rice equivalent amount of money. Okay, so let's say if your salary is whatever amount, 100 rupees, 500 rupees, 1000, whatever you feel here, ये पैसा नहीं भी होगा ना मेरे पास तो चलेगा. उसको पहले से पहले दिन से लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए इन्वेस्ट करो. ठीक है. नाउ एजुकेशन एंड बिल्डिंग द हाउस. ओके, आई थिंक आफ्टर यू सेटिंग अप द इमरजेंसी कॉर्पस एंड आफ्टर सेटिंग अप सम मनी विच यू नो यू विल टच फॉर योर फाइनेंशियल फ्रीडम, आई थिंक यू नो देन आफ्टर अ कपल ऑफ इयर्स यू नो यू विल हैव ऑल ऑफ दीज नीड्स एंड ड्रीम्स एंड गोल्स अबाउट बिल्डिंग हाउस एंड यू नो चिल्ड्रंस एजुकेशन एंड यू नो ऑल ऑफ दोज थिंग्स. So, उसके लिए भी यू नो इट विल ऑल फॉल इन द लॉन्ग टर्म कैटेगरी. सो वन बाय वन ऑल ऑफ दीज गोल्स विल बी वेरी इजीली फुलफिल इफ यू स्टार्ट विथ योर फाइनेंशियल फ्रीडम गोल फ्रॉम डे वन. फिर ये सारे दूसरे गोल्स इजीली फुलफिल हो जाए. एंड अगेन दिस वी हैव ऑलरेडी काइंड ऑफ डिस्कस्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ बाइफर्केटिंग द गोल्स एंड फिर उसके हिसाब से कहाँ पे इन्वेस्ट होना चाहिए. एंड you can always take help of any professional financial advisor who can help you do your financial planning. There are many apps which are available online which will help you do all of this, or else you can, you know, for example, we are also an online financial portal, our online financial planners, so we help a lot of people who are even outside Baroda and all that, you know, plan their financial needs. So we will not go into the details as of now, because I think we have many interesting things to cover up, and I have half an hour. That's it. Okay, so we have okay. So this is all about, like, you know, equity plans and all that. I think we can go further ahead. This is also again, like, you know, as I told you, liquid funds and FDs for parking cash, debt funds for income, equity funds are for growth. Okay, yeah, can we move ahead? Yeah, okay, this is interesting. Choose a set of funds that you that meet your need. Then so this is steps to building wealth. Setting up an SIP and invest every month. I'll explain in detail what is SIP. And review and increase your investment every year and add lump sums as you get them. Review of the portfolio of wherever you are investing is very important, and you should review it once in a year. Usse zyada you don't have to keep changing or churning and all that. And I'm sure you know you'll have methods to basically monitor your investments. Can we move to the next? Okay. This is, again, I discussed this earlier, that कई बार यू नो वो सब इन्वेस्टमेंट शेयर्स स्पेशली शेयर मार्केट में डर ज़्यादा लगता है, रिस्क ज़्यादा है. सो यू नो रादर देन रिस्किंग ऑल द मनी इन वन शेयर, ओके, इट इज बेटर टू हैव अ बास्केट ऑफ शेयर्स एंड दैट इज नथिंग बट अ म्यूचुअल फंड. सो इन्वेस्टिंग इन अ पोर्टफोलियो इज ऑलवेज बेटर.
और उसके लिए अगेन आई रिपीट कि ऐसा नहीं है दैट वी नीड टन्स ऑफ मनी एंड देन वी नीड टू सिलेक्ट एंड ऑल दैट. या सो नाउ कैन यू गो अहेड. ओके नाउ दिस इज आल्सो एक्सट्रीमली इंटरेस्टिंग. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू ट्रैक शेयर मार्केट्स जिसको जेन्युइनली इंटरेस्ट है शेयर मार्केट्स में? 1, 2, 3, 4. शेयर मार्केट में जो भी मंदी होती है तो कैसा लगता है? यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन देयर इज अ क्रैश इन द मार्केट? यू फील इट्स अ बैड डे, राइट? ओके सो व्हेन इज अ गुड डे ऑफ द मार्केट? इट्स अ गुड डे ऑफ द मार्केट, राइट? एंड व्हिच इज द वर्स्ट डे ऑफ द मार्केट? व्हेन इट फॉल्स. सो नाउ लेट अस रीड दिस दैट देयर आर टू न्यूज, गुड bad and good. The bad news is that the market cannot be predicted, right? Hum predict nahi kar sakte, right? That when it's going to go up, when it's going to go down and all that. But the good news is that it's not necessary in order to make money. Can you believe this statement? Ki market upar hai niche hai iski zarurat hi nahi hai agar tumko paisa banana hai market mein se to. Okay? The thing is that let me explain. Chahe wo particular day when the market is up or down, okay? Whether it is good or bad depends on which side of the market you are actually. If you want to invest, then the day when it is falling is the best day, you know, to basically invest. And when you have to, let's say, redeem for or you know, sell for any of your important goals, if you need money, then you should actually look at when the market is up, okay, so that you can pull it out from there. However, us dono ke beech ka jo time hai, which is time in the market, is most important. Okay, so anything which is more than 5 years in a good company or in a good mutual fund, this is an excellent time to, you know, be in the markets and really make a lot of money. Okay, now quickly for SIP samajhiye, because ye sab aapke liye bahut kaam aane wala hai once you actually step out into the big bad real world and when you actually start making your fantastic salary and dreams for all the dreams that you have. Invest a small sum regularly, build the investment habit. SIPs will actually help you build wealth. Okay? So it is really important कि हम loan लेते हैं तो bank को तो हम time पे you know पैसा दे देते हैं, लेकिन हम हमारे खुद के लिए नहीं invest करते, हम हमारे खुद के लिए नहीं सोचते हैं. So that is a habit that we have to develop of really investing for our own dreams, freedom, financial freedom, or जो भी हो. And invest and start with absolutely a small amount, even if it is a small amount. We will actually give you, after these slides are over, okay, one of my own slides, we will give you some thumb rules, which as soon as you step out into the world, or maybe now also if you are getting, if you have some funds or if you are participating with your parents in investment decision, to follow. Okay, so SIPs are systematic investment plan. Okay, basically small amount of money invested at regular intervals of time. Okay, so every month, it can be every week, it can be every month, it can even be every day. Okay, so it is exactly that. So okay, now with SIPs hota kya hai, we invest in the ups and downs. Dono mein invest hoga na, up hoga ya down hoga, kyunki isme to market dekhte hi nahi wale hai, right? So dono levels pe invest ho jayega. So we will get a very good averaging, okay? Yeah. Okay. Then as soon as and when your salary increases, you should actually do increase of the SIPs also. Or yeah, usko top ups bolte hain ki acha theek hai abhi mere ko bonus mila hai to thoda sa aur daal dete hain. Theek hai, and this again I repeat, it is for any goals which are for more than, yani jisme pata hai ki haan, you know, 3 years, 5 years and above wale. जो भी आपके ड्रीम्स या गोल्स होंगे उसके लिए ऑलरेडी बहुत अच्छे से पैसा इकट्ठा होता जाएगा जो कि इन्फ्लेशन को बीट करेगा. बिकॉज वी लेटर ऑन स्लाइड्स आई शो दैट इट इज इक्विटी मार्केट इज द प्लेस व्हिच इज एबल टू बीट इन्फ्लेशन. ओके सो एनीवेज गो अहेड. या सो दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंग. 2000 अ मंथ फ्रॉम योर फर्स्ट सैलरी परसिस्टेड इट फॉर 35 इयर्स यू विल हैव 1.2 क्रोर्स. सो यू कैन एक्चुअली रिटायर एट 35, यू नो, एज or maybe have a financial freedom at 35. Okay, so go on. Okay, so this is all about a slightly different topic, which is insurance.
because it is a part of financial planning. So just to quickly brush upon this. So humne sab investment ki baatein ki, theek hai? Now what is also important is that, you know, what if hum hi na aaye, right? All of you, you know, will after you pass out, like, you know, build a career, will get married and have a family and all that, right? So insurance is something that basically protects your family. Okay, so if you are not there, then the insurance company will actually give the money to the family so that you can actually, your family can live a comfortable life. So uske liye we have a product called insurance, okay, and it protects your family even against your liabilities. Assuming ki humne home loan liya hai, humne student loan liya hai, and you know we are earning, and hum log sabko to fast cars aur bike ka to bahut shauk hai. I think the biggest risk that all of us go through is dying early, right? Because hum jiyenge to sab kuch chhod lenge, jugaad kar lenge, but agar hum hum hi na rahe, then you know we don't want our loans to basically fall on our family. So for that also it's very important to take a simple term life cover. It is called term life cover, and it is very important. And the remaining thing I think is not applicable to you all at this stage, but still, there is something which is called as unit linked insurance plan. So insurance will be saving element hota hai kai products mein. यानी आपको वो इंश्योर भी कर रहे हैं और थोड़ा बहुत पैसा वो इन्वेस्ट भी करते हैं आपके बिहाफ में. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस रियली इज दैट देयर इज दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड यूनिट लिंक. इसमें द अमाउंट दैट यू मेक इज टैक्स फ्री. सो ये काफ़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है फॉर यंगर पीपल, बट योर एडवाइजर विल ऑलवेज गाइड यू बेटर. एंड देन देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड इज हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस. आई थिंक कोविड में मेनी ऑफ यू वुड हैव हर्ड दिस वर्ड अबाउट मेडिक्लेम एंड लाइक यू नो हाउ डिफिकल्ट और ईजी और यू नो वॉट एवर दिस. It's always better. Only one thing which I would urge you is the last point, that definitely see to it that your parents are covered before they turn 60. So aapke parents ko zarur ek cheez aap bata dijiyega ki it's better ki aapka medical cover hona chahiye before they turn 60, because then aage jaake it becomes much easier. After 60 the coverage bahut companies deti bhi nahi hai medical, or otherwise it becomes very expensive. So as maybe part of younger part of the family, you can at least make sure or tell your parents that, you know, this is what I have learned in the lecture today, ki hai na coverage apne paas hai. So that's the whole small point. Yeah, so this is, you know, which we have already kind of discussed in terms of need for financial freedom. Can we move on? Yeah, so now we have certain personal financial rules. जो मुझे लगा दैट यू नो इट विल बी रियली इम्पॉर्टेंट इफ यू ऑल न्यू दीज बेसिक्स एंड यू कैन एक्चुअली व्हाट आई डू इज एटलीस्ट फॉर दीज पर्सनल रूल्स. आई डोंट नो इफ यू वांट एनी अदर स्लाइड्स फ्रॉम अस, बट दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विच आई कैन सर्क्यूलेटेड टू योर फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड दे कैन इन टर्न सर्क्यूलेटेड टू यू पीपल. बट दीज आर थंब रूल्स विच इवन साइंस स्टूडेंट्स कैन यूज, कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स कैन ऑल्सो यूज वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग योर ओन पर्सनल फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग. एंड दीज आर वेरी सिंपल थिंग्स. The first one here will be, when do you want your money to be doubled? Okay, as you invested 10,000, 20,000, when will that 20,000 become 40,000? There is a simple rule of 72. So you divide the number of interest, matlab that FD mein rakhi hai, that FD is say 5%. Now divide that interest, divide 72 by the rate of your interest, so 72 by 5, whatever number you get, that many number of years, you double that 20,000 to 40,000, okay? So here there are examples for 6%, if it is 6%, it will be 12 years, if it is 9%, it will be 8 years. So second rule is rule of 70. Now, that is, you divide 70 by the rate of inflation. If the inflation is 7%, you divide it by 7. If the inflation is 6%, divide it by 6. So, what number do you get? You divide 70 by 7. It is 10, correct? So,
the value of money will reduce to half in next 10 years. जो 20,000 आपने रखा है, that will reduce to 10,000 in value after 10 years, considering the inflation is 7%. Okay? So we take the 100 minus age first. Now, what we discussed equity, we discussed debt. What is the ratio that you should ideally have in equity and in debt? At some point in your life, you are investing 1 lakh into the market or in FD or any other place. Abhi, aap 30 years ke ho at that point. So, subtract your age from 100. So, 100 minus 30 comes to 70. 70% of your allocation goes to equity and 30% goes to debt. As you grow older, you increase your debt allocation and decrease your equity allocation. That will also take care of your risk. Now, 4% rule for financial freedom. What is the corpus that you require at the end of the investment frame? 25 times of your estimated annual expense. Today your annual expense is say 10,000. That will increase over a period of time. So put 50% of this in fixed income and 50% into equity. Withdraw 4% every year. That is the 4% rule. Did I miss something? Yeah. So you have invested 5 lakhs. You redeem 4% every year from that corpus. That corpus will last you to the end of the time frame that you have decided initially. So 50-30-20 rule for allocation. You always put that, whatever age you are, doesn't matter. Always put this. 50% goes to your needs, the daily needs that you have, things that you cannot survive with. 30% goes to your entertainment, the wants, the vacations that you want to take in life. And 20% is always safe in equity or debt or any product that you want, but 20% always goes to savings. How we do is this bottom top. Save first, then you go to needs, and then you go to the 30% wants. Okay. 3-time emergency rule. Now, 3 times your monthly, you started your job, you are earning 30,000-40,000, multiply it by 3. That is the emergency corpus that you should always have. Say something happens, corona or you lose your job. The fund that you need to survive till you find something else is 3% your monthly income currently.
Thanks, Nupur. Absolutely important thumb rule, okay, which was, can I have the next slide? Okay. So anyway, so the 30-20 rule, can I have that slide again? No, this is not, yeah. The 50-30-20 rule, this is extremely important. Whenever you get your first salary onwards, right? जो मैंने पहले सबसे पहले जो starting में we began with rationalization of consumption, वो यही है. And if you just simply follow this, 20% hamesha should go for your investments, even if it is your first salary. And then 50% will be your needs, which includes your family, yourself, and all the, you know, your EMIs or whatever you have to pay. And 30% should go to your wants. So this rule is absolutely very important for all of you to understand. So if you just follow this one simple rule, okay, then 20% किसने भी इन्वेस्ट किया है, ओके,
अगेन कमिंग बैक टू दैट एसेट एलोकेशन, अगर वो ठीक से किया है then you know there is not a single need or dream of yours which you will not be able to fulfill. Just keep tracking your investments कि सही जा रहे हैं, कहीं हमसे कोई गलत कंपनी या गलत स्कीम तो नहीं सिलेक्ट हो गई, बस इसी को चेक करते रहे हैं and then you will see really the power of compounding kicking in just like that video. Okay, so yes, and 3% emergency rule which also I mentioned, so it's just this one slide, if you guys you know just follow and maybe take a picture or maybe whatever, you people are absolutely sorted for life and understanding inflation and power of compounding. कि इन्फ्लेशन को बीट करने के लिए कहीं ना कहीं मुझे पैसा कंपाउंड करना पड़ेगा सो दैट यू नो माय वेल्थ विल एक्चुअली ग्रो ओवर ओवर टाइम. या सो नाउ नेक्स्ट, या सो व्हाट आर द की पॉइंट्स, इट्स जस्ट अ रैप अप एंड देन आई जस्ट लाइक यू नो वी कैन ओपन द फ्लोर फॉर क्वेश्चंस और आई हैव सम मोर डेटा व्हिच आई कैन शेयर बिकॉज़ आई स्टिल हैव 15 मिनट्स विद यू गाइस आर interested, then you know we can explain a little more in terms of deeper, but this is just a wrap up. Key points to be kept in mind while investing. First of all, goals se jana hai. Okay, do goal based investing, classify your goals long term, short term, have a clarity ki isme se mujhe income chahiye ya growth chahiye, sabse zyada important. Then even understand your own risk appetite. See, sometimes because of certain situations that we have gone through in life, you know, we have lesser risk appetite. Okay, that you know, if we have seen, you know, our standard पर थोड़ा बिल पे लगा लिया, तो risk appetite कम हो जाएगा कि यार करना ही नहीं, पैसा नहीं घूमना चाहिए पैसा. But learn to manage this risk, learn to diversify this risk, learn to mitigate this risk. Okay, but ultimately invest as per your risk appetite. Risk appetite का मतलब basically is how much risk you can take. Okay, how much money you are ready to you know kind of let it fluctuate in terms of returns. And then once the investments are done, monitor it once in 3 months. Don't churn your investments too much because otherwise you will not give it enough time to really grow and mature. And automate the process of savings and investment and start early. Okay, there are lots of like you can SIPs and all of these things are extremely simple. You can you know just give an instruction to your advisor or to the bank or through the app or you know whichever way, it can easily happen. The first ko salary hai aur third ko invest ho bhi gaya. So you know that you have only X amount which remains to spend for your needs and wants. So automate the process and definitely have an aim and goal and reap the benefits of power of compounding for long term. So this is just the key points which you should keep in mind when you start investing. And now I would again, now we have just last 3 slides to go, so just to give you a heads up that just don't lose patience, it's just something and then of course we are here in the end. Something really interesting I want to ask you that whatever you hear in and around parents, TV, media, Google News, newspaper, you know, all of those things, you know, which asset class according to you, and कौन सा investment है जो अभी बहुत अच्छा चल रहा है? Idea? Any answers? Answers? Real estate is good. Okay, then gold कैसा चल रहा है? These are all general awareness. You know, कि पता होना चाहिए आजू बाजू क्या हो रहा है अपार्ट फ्रॉम बॉलीवुड एंड यू नो ऑल द अदर थिंग्स. म्यूचुअल फंड्स आर डूइंग गुड. ओके देन ओके प्रॉपर्टीज, ठीक है. सो म्यूचुअल फंड्स, प्रॉपर्टीज, शेयर मार्केट, ऑल ऑफ दिस, जस्ट लिटिल बिट हम लोग समझ लेते हैं कि क्या कितना रिटर्न दिया है. एंड इन्फ्लेशन, कैन यू ऑल गूगल, कैन यू ऑल यूज योर फोन्स एंड गूगल what is the and then I also give you the answer, what is the current inflation rate, aisa google karo and just see what the answers come up and tell me.
Right,
so 4 to 5% is the inflation which is
going on right now, okay, in this year. Now I give you one more figure. That long-term inflation हमने देखा, पेट्रोल और दूध के भाव का inflation देखा हमने, कितना था वो, anyone remembers? कितना attention दे दिया था slides के, जिससे videos के साथ में और videos बना के लाती, relevant videos. 7.5, yes. So that is the figure. So long-term inflation जो हमको actually में hit होता है, that is as of now close to around 7.5%, which basically means that any investment, if it gives me less than 7.5, okay, over a period of time, will it actually grow my wealth?
No.
It won't grow the wealth, right? Because inflation will eat it away. And हम जितना पैसा बना रहे हैं, let's say fixed deposit, हम 5% grow हो रहे हैं, ठीक है? लेकिन हमारी हम जो सब चीजें ले रहे हैं या लेने वाले हैं, that is growing at 7.5. So actually you are losing the power of your purchasing power of your money, right? So that is what, utility भी कम हो रही है और पैसे का purchasing power भी कम हो रहा है, right? That is what inflation is doing to you, to your wealth. So which basically means that हमको, we cannot invest in anything which gives us less than 7.5 for long term. Okay, अभी देखते हैं कैसे, how the returns have turned out to be in the 15 year and 20 year scenario and all that. See, if you see, just a quick, again numbers, but numbers, वो बोल रहे Asian Paints का ad है, हर घर कुछ कहता है, right? वैसे ये हर number के पीछे ना एक कहानी होती है. So, just trying to little bit, like you know, make you understand the कहानी behind the numbers. India का जो equity market है, okay, you will be surprised कि उसने किस तरह के returns दिए हुए हैं. 3 years में 16%, 5 years में 15%, 10 years में 13%, and अगर 15 year और 20 year देखे तो 10.2 and 14.8. So at every 1 year, 3 year, 5 year, 10 year, 15 year, अगर हमने डाल के छोड़ दिया, okay, समझो हमने exactly 1 year पहले invest किया होता इक्विटी मार्केट में, तो इट वुड हैव गिवन अस 31% रिटर्न. ओके, फिर अगर समझो 3 इयर्स के लिए गया तो इट इज अ लिटिल लेस ऑफ 16%. क्यों? बिकॉज बीच बीच में वोलेटिलिटी आता है, ये एक साल अच्छा जा सकता है, यू नो लास्ट ईयर बिकॉज कोविड में से हम लोग बाहर निकले तो बहुत ज्यादा रिटर्न दिखा है, बट इट इन एवरेज आउट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. बट लेट अस लुक एट द 15 ईयर पीरियड, इज अराउंड 10% रिटर्न इज व्हाट इट हैज डिलीवर्ड. Then if you see US equities, okay, US का जो market है, okay, technically it gives, it grows lesser than India over a 20 year period, but in a 15 year period it has given a 12% kind of return. So what I told you कि जैसे आप लोग crypto track करते हो या देखते हो, at least people who are already interested in the stock markets, you can actually track Google shares and FD shares also if you are interested. और वो इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हैं, बट टेक सम एक्सपर्ट हेल्प और टेक एडवाइजर्स हेल्प एंड प्लीज कंसल्ट योर पेरेंट्स बिफोर यू इन्वेस्ट. अभी डेट, डेट यानी हर तरह का फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट, गवर्नमेंट बॉन्ड, सब कुछ, उसके रिटर्न्स किस तरह से दिखते हैं, देखते हैं. सो 1 ईयर इज अराउंड 4%, 3 ईयर में था 7.5, 7.8.1, 15 ईयर 7.9 एंड 20 ईयर 7.5. तो चलो हम 20 ईयर का भी लेते हैं, 7.5, okay? It is only been equal to inflation. यानी जितना मेरे पेट्रोल का भाव बढ़ा, उतना ही मेरे बैंक एफडी ने मुझे दिया. Has it actually increased anything beyond? So can I do anything which is beyond filling up petrol in my car? No, right? So these are things if you understand at an early age, it's really better. But does that mean that bank FD is bad? No, again no. Why? Because bank FD को अपना काम करना है, उसको कम रिस्क में और बहुत ही कम रिस्क में और रेगुलर रिटर्न्स देना है उसको. दैट इज हिज जॉब. सो इमरजेंसी पर्पस के लिए इन्वेस्ट करो, शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए, वो सबके लिए बैंक FD ठीक है, सिर्फ लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए बैंक FD ठीक नहीं है. ओके, सो दैट इज द पॉइंट दैट आई वॉन्ट टू मेक हियर. सो लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए बाकी सारी चीजें हैं जो आप कंसिडर कर सकते हैं, इवन गोल्ड फॉर दैट मैटर. ओके, गोल्ड इंटरेस्टिंग, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एज अ क्लास. And very changing also, because I believe the
mindset of people are also changing. 1 year, it is giving only 3% return. It's not even beaten inflation. Forget about it. Then 3 years it is better because sales are finished, gold card dipped up. So 16.9% whatever. Then 5 years it is given 11. Not 10 years. Imagine we say 10 se 16 leke rakh diya. ठीक है, but अगर CAGR निकालने बैठे तो सिर्फ 4% निकलता है. Okay, then again 15 year and 20 year, it is very different numbers. Okay, so the whole thing is that gold is very very long term. इसके बहुत लंबे लंबे cycles होते हैं. So gold definitely it is again, is it a bad asset class? No, right? It is also an asset class जो बहुत different तरीके से उसको देखना चाहिए. Preservation of wealth की तरह से देख सकते हैं. Then future consumption. Okay, all the girls and all the boys out here, all of you want to get married, right? और हमारे हम लोग इंडिया वाले हैं, हमारे में तो गोल्ड हम लोग खरीदते हैं, पहनते हैं और ना, so only that much. उससे beyond बहुत ज़्यादा ऐसे उसमें invest कर देना शायद सही नहीं है, because times are changing. So again, yeah, this we did. The next slide. Let me just have the graphs. Yeah. So this is interesting. Okay, ये इसमें हमारे पास कौन से ईयर से डेटा है. सो दिस इज लाइक अ वेरी लॉन्ग टर्म डेटा दैट वी हैव राइट फ्रॉम 89. ओके, 1989 से लेकर 2001 के डेटा है जहाँ पे हमेशा इकोनॉमी हमारी कैसी है. लाइक यू नो एनी इकोनॉमी एनी कंट्री अप्स एंड डाउन्स तो आते हैं जिंदगी की तरह. ये जिंदगी का ग्राफ दिखता है मेरे को. यू नो दैट अप्स एंड डाउन्स आर गोना बी देयर. ओके, समथिंग और द अदर विल कीप ऑन हैपनिंग. कभी कुछ इंडिया ये चाइना का अपना पार्टीशन हो गया 47 में, उसके बाद यू नो वी स्टार्टेड ग्रोइंग एंड अगेन कुछ वॉर हो गया, देन वी हैड ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस व्हिच हैपेंड इन द ईयर. ओके, इन व्हिच ईयर डिड द ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस हैपेंड? लाउडर आई कांट हियर. या 2008. या एनी अदर आंसर्स? No, so it is 2008 is the correct answer. 2008-9, okay, was global financial crisis. जो कि US से शुरू हुआ था, एक बैंक पूरी कोलैप्स हो गई थी. Okay, so ये सब भी होता है. Then उसके बाद क्या हुआ? We have some or the other dot-com bubble happened in the year 2000. और अभी latest क्या हुआ? What was the latest that happened? क्या हुआ latest? COVID. Yes, so we had a pandemic. Imagine something, एक ऐसा सिचुएशन आया कि पूरी की पूरी कंट्रीज बंद करनी पड़ी. इमेजिन लाइक यू नो the इकोनॉमी द फ्लो ऑफ गुड्स पीपल सिर्फ एक ही फ्लो चालू था, इंफॉर्मेशन का फ्लो चालू था, राइट? बाकी गुड्स का फ्लो स्टॉप हो चुका था फॉर सम पॉइंट इन टाइम एंड इवन ओनली एसेंशियल गुड्स वर ऑन एंड देन व्हाट हैड हैपेंड इवन द फ्लो ऑफ पीपल स्टॉप. वो तो अभी भी मुश्किल से खुल रहा है. लाइक यू नो देयर आर ऑलवेज क्वेश्चन मार्क्स ऑन दैट. So only thing that was happening was information flow. Apart from that, all flows had stopped. And money flow was also going on. Because now money is electronically transferred, okay, from one country to the other. So the whole point that I want to make over here is that it's not a safe ride. It is a bumpy ride out here. Okay? But again, if you follow the 2-3 steps, one is do small investment at regular periods of time. यहीं से पैसा बनना है. आई मीन यू नो दिस इज अ ग्रेट प्लेस टू मेक मनी बट दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी रिस्की. सो हाउ डू वी मिटिगेट रिस्क एंड हाउ डू वी स्प्रेड द रिस्क इज बेसिकली डू स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर्स बट एट रेगुलर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ओके, फॉलो द 50-30-20 रूल एज आई टोल्ड यू. पॉइंट नंबर 2. पॉइंट नंबर 3 इज दैट रादर देन इन्वेस्टिंग इन वन पर्टिकुलर स्कीम और स्टॉक, invest in a bag, invest in a portfolio. So that will also help you diversify the risk. Okay, abhi today when we make portfolio of India and abroad, India and global stocks. Is tarah ke bhi portfolios mutual funds mein available hai. So utilize all of that and again most important thing, have patience. Okay, so now the last PowerPoint slide. Yep, guys, we are done. Guys, have any question we can take or we can actually it's finished exactly on time. So this is just one colorful slide which just says that har ek saal mein na alag alag investment class perform karta hai. But again, the moral of the story is
remain diversified and as a country. Thank you.